I've changed it up a little bit. Now we're using a big fuel tank here, which gives us more than the other one we were using. This has got 720 liquid fuel, and the one we've been using gives us 360. So double that, and also double the mass. But, I don't know. I'm hopeful that this will do something. And I'm pretty sure the instability we had was not because of this. It was because of the triple docking garbage I had going on down there. I'm also going to add a little bit more SAS to this hog because we were getting some wonk. And I'm a fan of wonk, but not when it comes to rocketry. I still don't know if we can afford to turn... I had to turn this one back from a poodle into a skipper because we didn't have enough thrust to get it up there. So I think we're going to keep that as it is and just hope that this is going to do it. Because the Zenata Mark III, I had to scrap the nuke completely, and now we're going to go without it. And I've just... The Zenata Mark III was useless, so we're redesignating this the Zenata Mark III, and we're going to hope that this will work. I don't know. At this point, we're just throwing stuff at the wall, seeing what sticks. It's one way to learn. Round 7,000, but if you look carefully, you'll notice that we're actually going pretty slow in relation to the planet right now. We hit it at its fastest point and our fastest point. So in relation to the sun, we're both going very fast, but in relation to each other, we're going very slowly. And the good news is that we haven't used any of our atomic engine's fuel at all yet. Plus, we've got extra fuel in the probe. So I am actually pretty hopeful here. Now we're going to start doing our retro burn early. There's very little fuel left in this guy here, so we're just going to burn him off. Like that. Okay. And I want to make sure my stages are correct. Thank you for not exploding, atomic engine. And now this atomic engine's got a lot of mass to slow down because there's a crap load of fuel in here. But it should be enough fuel to get the job done. I hope. We're slowing awfully slowly, but once again, crossing our fingers, hoping for the best. Will you look at that? Not only are we here, we're in orbit, and we've got fuel left for our atomic to get us into a better orbit for an approach to landing. Oh yeah, we got a shot at this one. So I think we're going to go ahead and hit our applesauce, and I don't even need to plan this. I can just do this by hand. Where we're going to shrink our orbit to around 100,000 or 200,000. Yeah, we'll go with 200,000. Oops, I forgot to turn myself. Fortunately, this thing has got a pretty good turn rate in space. So this will get us nice and low to the flow. And then we'll do another burn. And then we'll be able to maybe even use the atomic engine to control our descent onto the planet and then jettison it when we're ready to do the rest with our little engine, which has got twice as much fuel as we had last time. So, all in all, pretty... If it weren't for my own idiocy, this is a foregone conclusion. Unfortunately, I'm an idiot. So, it's very possible that this will not work at all. Having said that, I think we're going to be okay. Not really happy with the orientation of this orbit, but it is what it is. Oh yeah, we got a ton of fuel left after this. Yeah, we'll be able to slow ourselves down to a very nice chunk before we even attempt to land. So we can actually pick our landing location, which is also really useful. And we're there. So we got about 185 and 200. Not exactly circular, but whatever. I'm thinking something like right here would be a good spot. That big open crater right there on the side. It's a big smack face. It could be a little difficult to manage the actual technical aspect here, considering what we'll have to end up doing in order to get this to work. Okay. Yeah, that's about where we would want it to be started, and then we can do another retro burn right here. So if we do this burn here, it'll get us to the point where if we screw up, we can always go back around for another try. That's a 2-minute burn, really? Wow. Well, this atomic engine's slow, and we're carrying a lot of fuel, so hopefully we've got enough fuel to get ourselves in the right spot and decelerate it. It might be greedy for me to try this, but we're going to try anyway. So at about 1 minute, we'll do a controlling burn and get ourselves a nice orbit. This is not at all what I had planned for. I don't know exactly what it thinks it's doing, but this is not the maneuver that I had intended. Is it gonna... How are we gonna work this? How is it going to deal with this? I'm also not a big fan of these explosion noises that I'm hearing. Okay, we've got this part. Now, how do we get it to turn the other way? Oh, it's slowly doing it. Okay. Yeah, this is a big waste of fuel as far as being greedy about our landing spot. We could just land there, but no, we're going to go for this big old crater over here. I think we can afford it. We've got tons of fuel. This many tons of fuel, so I think it'll be okay. Okay, there's our new orbit, and now we can just plan on a retro burn right here. Get ourselves a nice swoop down, nice and easy, right in the middle of that little lake bed there, or whatever the hell that thing is. And then we can actually do some serious sciencing on the surface of Mo-Ho-Ho. This planet is Santa Claus. Okay, 1 minute, 23 second burn. We got plenty of fuel for that, and we wait. Pretty excited about this. Whoops, I missed my burn point, so we'll overshoot it slightly, but whatever. Whatever, man. Like, I give a fuck. I got fuel coming out of my fuel hole. This is how you land a fucking probe. With a huge tank of gas. And a nuke. That's how we land probes here in the Jeff Research Division, anyway. We blow them up with nukes. Okay, you're not useful anymore. We're just gonna slow down. God, that's so much fuel. We'll be able to do a lot of other things with this craft now. Plus, hopefully we'll unlock some new proby-type things so that we can extend our probitude. I'm really excited to use this seismic thing, too. We've never even used it, and we're going to end up using it on an entirely different world. How cool is that? And a world that, from my understanding, at least from my experience, is hopefully one of the hardest ones to land on. Because if it's not, then we're in big trouble. You like my reasoning there? It had better be. Okay. Now we fall. Now this is particularly one of my areas of expertise. Falling. I just have to stay patient and ease it in. I said ease it in, not at 400 meters per second. That is not easing. And we have to remember that this thing has very little thrust, so we really, really do have to be careful to ease it in. I'm going to skip a bit of the descent, and I'll be back when we get around 20,000 meters or so. Okay, we're at 12,000 meters now, and we're doing a very serious retrograde burn to slow ourselves down, because we are still going over 200 meters per second. Now we're under 10,000. I'm a little concerned about this now. I think we'll be okay. Oh no, that's... Yeah, no, we're fine. But just barely fine. This guy here's still got a ton of fuel left. Not literally a ton, but quite a bit. And now we can just coast on down for a bit. Or slowly, you know, ish. I'll get it down to 50 meters per second for this part here. We are at some point going to jettison this thing. It'll still have fuel in it, but these are the costs. Wasting a bit of fuel is the cost of science. We're accelerating towards this thing really fast. It is very, very strongly pulling us now. 3,000 meters. Happy with my angle here. Let's just coast it on in. Nice and smooth. Hi, sun. Keep me charged. There's a lot of gritty detail on this thing. And we're at 2,000 meters. Awesome. Things are looking good. This is a perfect landing spot. Nice and flat looking. Looks like it's got tire tracks on it. So we'll have traction for our probe. Haha, see? You guys thought I was inefficient. Well, I was, but look where my inefficiencies got me. My deficiencies and inefficiencies are more effective than your efficiencies. Deal with it, shades. Okay, we're under 500. And we are very slowly coasting down. And now I'm going to do the... Oh, hey. Good time to do that. Okay. That thing ran out of fuel. Boy, we hit the nail on the head with this one. Thank you for your stuff, Nuke. Sorry for nuking your planet, Duna. It's really nothing personal. I just have science that I'd like to do. Hopefully we won't have irradiated the area that we are planning to do our science at. But there's something really weird about landing on this planet. We accelerate towards it faster than I am expecting to. Like this. Okay. Dropping like a rock. Not perfect, but we did it! Okay, hold off on the science for a minute. Let's just think about that. For the first time in my experiences with the Kerbal Space Program videos, we have landed on another planet, unassisted by mods, all vanilla, using our own research tech. We have got a probe on another world. Look at literally how far we've come. Boop, boop. And we're at a good starting point, because this is the one that's closest to the sun. Got nice and charged up. Now let's see what we can do as far as science. Seismic data. The sensors detect vibrations deep inside the planet. It appears the interior is very volcanically active. Scientific value, 500. Oh yeah, we're getting ourselves some fucking mainsail. Send that shit home right now. We need that shit. That is going to take a long time to transmit. We could only send 50% of one transmission on the current battery charge. This is going to take a while. I should have sent more batteries on this fucking thing. Alright, I've been transmitting for a little bit. It turns out that the seismic thing is actually the biggest, and it's really nice because it transmitted a 60% rate. Unlike the materials bay, which only does 120. I've already done a couple of these, but if I go to... Oops, let's trash that. I hope that didn't do something stupid. Yeah, the materials bay is 216, and it only transmits at 20%. So it's going to take a while for us to do this, but we're going to get everything. The mystery goo was not that big a deal. You observe the goo. There was about a total of, I think, 80 available for that, and then nothing for the barometer, but a little bit for the temperature. So we've got a lot of science to get. A lot. And I'll be here for a while doing that. Okay, I think we've mined all the available datums from MOHO, which is fucking cool. Let's take a ride around the MOHO-mobile here for a minute and just enjoy the view from another place in the universe. Not drastically different. Now, my thermometer is not working. I don't know why, but it's saying... Oh, well, that now it says there's no power. But when it does have power, it says that the temperature is zero. And I don't believe it. Okay, somehow it got power even though there's no sunlight, but whatever. Let's see here. Yeah, display is 0.00. That's not right. That number is wrong. And I really don't know how we got that power burst. Because there's no sun. There's the sun! Okay. Temperature still zero. So yeah, I don't know if it's maybe because it's intersecting with the solar panel, but it's not giving me the correct thing. And we've got enough scientific value out of this thing that everything's down to bare minimums. But we did it! We finally did it. We've gone to another world. We've achieved a science on it. And the question I have is, I've got a full tank of gas here. I'm pretty sure we can't get back to Kerbin. It'd be a lot of extra points if we could, but I'm pretty sure we can't. So, do we leave this here? Yeah, we'll leave this here for now. I think we'll leave this guy as a monument to our conquest of Moho. You've been conquistadored. One thing I didn't check is, let me just check this real quick. I wonder if it says anything about there being a range. No, just Moho's surface. So, yeah, there we go. We did it. Now we get to roll around in science. There should be somewhere around, like, 600 or 700 or something like that. Science points we got from this. Maybe more. I don't know. But yeah, let's go see. The other good thing is that that thing is flight ready to go somewhere else, too. 900 science points. Oh yeah. I know I want this, but I don't know if I want it right now. Because I'm pretty happy with what we got out of the last one. And we could get, for example, we could get two of these, or we could get one of those and then one of these as well. I do want a little more science. Determining the precise strength of gravitational fields. And I love graviolis. They're delicious. There's good stuff all over down here. We don't have enough to get 2 500-ers. Plus, I'd also like to get this thing here for extra probiness. And that for space station-iness. But this, you know what? We're going to get this. This is like an essential thing. This will guarantee the future of our ability to do mega launches. It's much better than the one that we've been using, or at least I'm pretty sure it is. And I don't even know if we'll tweak the one. Yeah, we'll probably do. We'll refit our Zenata craft and probably give it a new designation. Now we've got enough to get another one of these things. We could get large electronics or field science. And I'm curious because I like rovers. I want to see what this gives us as far as rover tech. Okay, these are the useful rover parts. So we're getting to the point where we might be able to make rovers soon. We still got a ways to go in that regard. But I'm really happy with how far we've come so far. And we still got some really cheap tech back here we've never picked up. Because we just have never really gone into the whole space plane thing. But I like specializing. This is nice. And it looks like this is the highest tier rocketry we've got so far. Available in this version of the game. And I'm happy with that because that's the best I can even imagine. So I think we're going to go ahead and take a little break. And then we're going to refit and redesignate the Zenata. And probably repurpose it for another mission somewhere else. I don't think we'll be doing the carpet bombing of the moon with probes until we get something more along the lines of either this or this or this plus whatever this is extra kind of thing. We may not be able to get this until we've unlocked all of these things here. We've got a ways to go as far as our probe tech and solar panels and electricity, and I would like to get this. This is actually pretty important, too. It's a much larger battery. And considering we're working with a fairly large scientific thing, then we might be able to use that. Now, one other thing I'd like to say is that materials research bay, it's good science, it takes forever to use, and it's heavy, and it ensures that I have to have a large probe, so I might even consider doing away with that if we have trouble getting to the next portions of the planets. But I think we're okay, and I think that next time when we head out, we can just go ahead and pick a planet and try to punch it in the face with our rocket, because we had extra fuel pretty much from our trip to Moho. So yeah, I think next time we'll head for Eve and see what we can discover about Eve. And then there's always Duna and Drez and Jewel and Elu, and we got a ton of places to go and reasons to go there now. I forgot to mention one thing. Now that we've gone to Moho, I'll read off the information from Moho. Moho figures into Kerbal mythology as a fiery place with oceans of flowing lava. In reality, however, it is much less interesting. Scientists speculate about possible ways to make it awesome, like in the stories. Some of those ideas have led to new breakthroughs in aerospace technology. They have, like mainsail rockets. Its physical characteristics are that it's 250,000 or 250 kilometers equatorial radius. It is big and massive, and its age, sex, location, gravity is 0.27. The escape velocity is very low. It's got a 14-day rotational period, which is very long. The sphere of influence is very, very small, and it has no atmosphere. So those are what we've discovered about MOHO. Now, I won't read off this stuff for the other planets until we go there, but I do know, for example, that we're probably going to go to Eve next, and one thing that we do know is that Eve has a moon, and how do we see if we can get this moon under control at the same time we probe the planet? That is our challenge. Next time!